name is Sidney Reist, and I'm a project coordinator with the Ellis Don Kinetic Joint Venture at the University of Victoria Student Housing and Dining Project. During our last site walk, we had just finished pouring the level one concrete and we were preparing to pour the level two concrete. Now, today, as you can see, we've made it up to the level five concrete and we're also starting to do the interior and exterior layout for the drywall.
Here you can actually see on my left a structural schematic of building one. So you can see that the building is primarily made of concrete all the way from level six on the south wing to level eight on the north wing. But here you can see some of the wood mass timber sections along what we like to call the mass timber podium.
You can see behind me that we are standing right below the mass timber podium right off of Ring Road on Building 1. Mass timber is a structural engineered product that takes large solid wood panels and glues them together in such a way that it creates a solid structural product. So here I have two samples, one of glue laminated timber and one of cross laminated timber. The cross laminated timber has the wood panels glued together in such a way that the wood grains are alternating each other by 90 degrees in the stack. This provides multi-directional strength, which is why they're typically used for long spans. Glue laminated timber, on the other hand, has the wood panels glued together in such a way that the wood grains are aligned, which primarily provides strength along one axis, which is why they're typically used as columns. Here you can see an example of what the glue lam columns that are going to be exposed are going to look like. And for me, this is one of my favorite parts of the project because I love to see the contrast of the mass timber wood against the concrete building. So the mass timber that we're using on this project, specifically for building one, has been sourced from a BC company who sources all of their wood from the Kootenay region. So that means that the mass timber on this project has been grown, harvested, and processed all within the province. The mass timber columns that you can see here on my right, they will be exposed as they are considered more of an architectural feature as well as structural. But as we move up into the second level, the floors will be covered in typical flooring, but we'll be able to see some of the CLT and glue lam beams in the roof section. Mass timber has become more and more popular to use in the last few years for building construction, and this is primarily because of the sustainability benefits. Incorporating mass timber into building design can lower the environmental impact primarily by lowering the carbon footprint. Now, this is because mass timber uses wood resources instead of energy or fossil fuel intensive products such as steel and concrete. Design and construction of the new buildings will meet Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, also known as LEED, version 4 Gold, and Passive House Standards, which are the most rigorous global building standards for sustainability and energy efficiency. Using renewable building materials and pursuing sustainable certifications such as Passive House and LEED is our opportunity to be a good example to other companies in the community, but also to provide a positive impact on the environment for such a huge industry.